Squeeze me. Be mine. Hubba Hubba. You've probably seen these heart-shaped candies around because everyone's favorite Hallmark holiday is here. And these got me thinking, what's the history on some of our Valentine's Day favorites? First up, these little heart-shaped candies go all the way back to 1866, when a guy named Daniel Chase at New England Confectionery Company, aka Necco, developed a machine that could press food dye letters onto candy. The hearts evolved into the ones we know today and continue to be made every year from late February to mid-January. During that time, around 8 billion, or 100,000 pounds, of candy hearts are made, and the entire amount is sold out within 6 weeks. To this day, sweethearts are the best-selling Valentine's Day candy. Wow, that's a lot of sugar, sugar! And if it's not heart-shaped candy, it's heart-shaped boxes of chocolate, which were created specifically for Valentine's Day by a guy named Richard Cadbury of the Cadbury Company in 1861. Now a staple for well over 100 years, there's more than 36 million sold around the world. The funny thing about this holiday is it's named after two or more Roman saints named Valentine, unconnected with romantic love. The first mention of St. Valentine's Day as a romantic holiday appeared in the writings of Geoffrey Chaucer in 1382. For this was on St. Valentine's Day, when every bird cometh there to choose his mate. Finally, there's nothing more classic than a V-Day dinner, and being I'm a dad at home, I decided to pull out all the stops for my little Valentine in a Beauty and the Beast feast. May this rose ignite love everywhere.
Both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast.
So whether it be sweets, flowers, dinner, may we all spread that extra love this year. Or as my wife's saying this year, you'll do.
Happy Valentine's!